I'm sure you've already heard plenty about how it's massive streams of data that often define the way we shop, drive, learn, and play, and even the way we interact with health and government services. And I'm sure you already know that there's so much new data being generated each minute that finding places to store it is a significant challenge, much less properly analyzing it. I write a bit about the device-to-data pipeline in my Keeping Up, Backgrounders to All the Big Technology Trends You Can't Afford to Ignore book. But here I'm going to spend a minute or two talking about the analytics end of the data ecosystem. What are the most effective tools for converting all that data to knowledge and insights? Of course, there are hundreds of tools for consuming and processing data out there, stretching across a handful of categories. Spreadsheets, for example, can be convinced to do some pretty impressive things with data, perhaps more than you would imagine. Google Data Studio lets you visualize and share complex data sets through interactive dashboards and reports. Microsoft's Power BI, where BI stands for Business Intelligence, has had success providing business end users with the ability to similarly visualize an organization's data and share insights through a simple browser interface. The claim of all these products is that they make it easier for you to create fairly sophisticated and effective presentations of your data. And there's definitely truth to the claim. But sometimes easy just isn't the right approach. Sometimes your data isn't a great fit with off-the-shelf tools, or the kinds of insights you're after require too much customization. Or sometimes there's so much data that normal front-end applications just aren't up to the task. In such cases, there's no alternative to booting up a programming environment and diving in yourself. When it comes to programming languages for handling data, there are only two names to remember, Python and R. Python, by the way, happens to be my weapon of choice. And many, perhaps most people working in the data analytics world, choose Jupyter Notebooks as the platform where they run their code. Notebooks allow you to run programs a single command at a time and save their code in a format that can easily be shared. If your organization isn't generating any interesting data in-house, you should take a look around the internet for endless sources of valuable public data sets. There's so much out there waiting to be discovered and analyzed. There are government sites like the U.S. Department of Labor's Bureau of Labor Statistics, records of parliamentary proceedings, international public policy and economic performance statistics, or even sports stats. In many cases, the data can be accessed directly from your programming environment through published APIs. Interested in learning data analytics for yourself? After all, why should other people have all the fun? Why not check out some of my own articles documenting a half dozen or so of my own data adventures using Python on Jupyter Notebooks? You can get there using datasite.bootstrap-it.com.